Welcome back. Radioactive iodine has been used successfully as a therapy for thyroid disease for more than 50 years. Today, a treatment option aimed at improving patient outcomes in thyroid cancer. Take a look.
The minute that I heard the word cancer, I immediately went to death sentence.
They found out that I had something weird in my neck. I got this bad news that I have cancer, and then I have to think about my life now.
To tell a patient that they have cancer is always very, very difficult. But it's also an opportunity to look at helping someone through what may be a very trying and stressful time for that patient.
The first thing that flashed through my mind was, I'm not going to see my son grow up.
The hardest part was stopping everything, stopping my life. I was involved in my school, and someone told you, no, it's over for now. You just have to press pause. Why?
The chance of being diagnosed with thyroid cancer has risen in recent years and is the most rapidly increasing cancer in the United States, with numbers almost tripling in the past three decades. Although surgery remains the current standard of care, statistics are showing that with the addition of radioactive iodine therapy, physicians can significantly improve outcomes. And joining us today is Dr. Douglas Van Nostrand, Director of Nuclear Medicine and Research at MedStar Washington Hospital Center. Doctor, thank you so much for joining us today.
My pleasure.
So let's get right into it. Can you describe thyroid cancer for us?
There's really four types of thyroid cancers, and they're based upon the types of cells that are found within the thyroid. And there are what's called well-differentiated thyroid cancers, and that's papillary and follicular. And there's very rare cancers called medullary and anaplastic. The predominant ones that we experience are papillary and follicular cell thyroid cancers.
So, doctor, how are we currently treating thyroid cancer?
There's three core components that are considered for the treatment of thyroid cancer, well-differentiated thyroid cancer. Surgical removal, a radioiodine therapy, and administration of thyroid hormone. Now, in regard to the surgery, the goal of the surgery is hopefully to cure that thyroid cancer by removing it completely. And then based upon the specific situation of each patient, radioiodine may be administered because there may be the possibility that thyroid cancer cells are left behind, and the radioiodine would then go to those thyroid cancer cells and kill those thyroid cancer cells, helping again to minimize the likelihood that there would be any recurrence later on and achieving a cure for that patient. Now, the interesting thing about radioiodine is that those thyroid cells and the thyroid cancer cells have a unique ability to want to take up that iodine because they need the iodine in order to make thyroid hormone. So we're taking advantage of that by having, if you will, a magic bullet that is radioactive that will then be specifically taken up by those thyroid cells, cancer cells, and then when they're in that particular cell, irradiate that cell and kill it.
Amazing. So, doctor, how is radioactive iodine administered? Because I think I speak for a lot of us who they hear the word radiation or radioactive and they're concerned.
Well, the radioactive iodine is put inside of a capsule, and then the capsule is taken by the patient orally. It goes down through the stomach and the intestines, and then it's absorbed into the blood supply. But the beauty of this treatment is that the radioiodine that's not taken up by those thyroid cancer cells is relatively rapidly eliminated from the body, and it's eliminated through the urine, through the kidneys, and through the GI tract. Now, one concern that comes up that you raised earlier is about radiation and radioactivity, and when anybody talks about radiation or radioactivity, the first thing they say is, well, this is cancer, this is going to cause cancer. And it's a concern, but generally speaking, when one looks at the side effects of radioiodine from a first or second treatment, the increased risk of any type of other cancer is very, very low.
Doctor, what are the benefits of radioactive iodine, and are there any side effects?
There's really three potential benefits for the patient. The first, it can aid the physician who's going to follow this patient in order to look for recurrence of the thyroid cancer. The second is it reduces the likelihood of recurrence in patients. By receiving the radioiodine, one reduces recurrence rate. And the third is in patients who have had recurrence rate, it can extend life. Now, radioiodine, like any treatment, has side effects. Mm-hmm. The treatment of radioiodine, patients can have some nausea, and occasionally there is vomiting. One can get swelling and pain in their salivary glands. The salivary glands accumulate the iodine like the thyroid does. But with preventive medicines, one can help reduce the likelihood and the severity of that. And there's a lot of things that we can do with that. However, most people tolerate the radioiodine fairly well.
That sounds like it could be a great option for many people. Let's check in with our patients.
The reaction that I had to the radioactive iodine was very minimal, so there is no hair loss or anything like that. The side effects that I immediately felt, I was a little nauseous. One of the biggest fears that I faced after getting over the initial fear of having cancer was, will the radioactive iodine inhibit my ability to have another child? I was very blessed to have another son 5 years ago.
Having cancer, for me, it brings me a totally different ways of approaching life because I'm more alive than ever.
That was so nice to see. So, Doctor, what educational resources are available for families and patients?
Well, I'm really pleased that you asked that question because that's a very important issue for me. And there's many resources that are available. They include many patient books, many thyroid cancer support groups that are online, and a new one that I'm excited about is called TIME. And the TIME stands for thyroidectomy surgery, iodine, the radioiodine therapy, monitoring, and expectations. And this is, I think, a really good program to help organize the patient to be their own advocate, but also to have a framework in order to work with the physician regarding what's the appropriate care for their particular thyroid cancer.
Doctor, thank you so much for coming here today. All this great information, helping keeping our viewers informed. Combination therapies and treatment, including radioactive iodine, are a powerful component in the battle against certain types of thyroid cancer. Ask your doctor if it may be right for you. For more information on radioactive iodine therapy, please visit draximage.com/TIME. And of course, you can always go to our website, accesshealth.tv. Don't forget to follow us on Facebook and Twitter.